Hi, this is COMP1010 at the University of Manitoba. I'm Dr. Celine LaTulip, and today I'm going to be talking to you about converting between strings and other types. So numbers are often represented in a lot of different ways. It depends on the language and the alphabet and the character set. So the number 5 has all these different representations. So these are all different text variations of the concept number 5, which is an abstract idea of a quantity. So this may lead you to question, is the string 5 in processing different than the integer 5? And the answer is yes, they are different types, and you have to be careful about using them interchangeably. So string is text and it's language dependent, and numbers are just an abstract concept. So these two variations, 1234.56 and 1234.56 with the comma in it, are both two different string representations. They are equivalent to this abstract number, 1234.56. So if we wanted to try some conversions, we'll see that we run into trouble when we try to go from ints to strings. So in this example, we've created a string variable s, we've assigned it the string 5 because we put it in quotation marks, and then we have an int variable I, and we try to assign s into that. So we're trying to copy this string into this int. This will give us an error. If you try to do this in processing, you'll see this type mismatch. Javalang string does not match with int. And it doesn't work the other way around either, typically. So here we have int j, and we're assigning it the number 5 because it's an integer. And then we're trying to take this int 5 and assign it to the string s2. Remember, strings are these complex objects that have multiple different characters and so on. So saying we want 5 to be converted into that, Java doesn't quite know what to do with that. So in this case, we'll get a similar error when we're trying to do that kind of conversion. So if we want to turn something into a string, we need to do basically, in some sense, it's like an explicit cast, but we're going to use this string function and pass in the thing we want to change into a string. So processing will sometimes automatically do this conversion if processing knows it needs a string, but it won't do it for you in terms of putting it into a string unless you use str like this. So in this case, if we have int I equals 5, and then we say string s, and instead of just assigning I to s, we say string of I, this will be okay. Processing will say, okay, we're going to just take this 5, and we're going to put quotations around it and store it as the string 5. And here we can do the same thing when we're trying to print out or display text on the canvas. We can pass in a number, but pass it in through str, and it will become like this. This is one of those cases where processing will actually do this for you without using the str. So if you do this, processing knows that the first parameter of the text function needs to be a string. It'll take this number and just turn it into a string and print it out. So there are occasions where processing will do an automatic conversion for you. There's also this other trick way. If you want to turn a number into a string, we can use the rules of concatenation and concatenate an empty string with a number, and this will turn this automatically into a string and add it to the empty string, so then we'll have the string 2345. So here's an example of that. String s equals my age, and then we concatenate s with the number 19. This internally gets rewritten as s equals s plus string of 19. It will just sort of, this is where processing is doing an automatic conversion for you. It converts 19 to 19 in quotations and creates a string that is my age 19. So strings that are actually represent numbers that are valid numbers can be converted into integers. And this is like harder to do, and it only works if the string really does represent a valid number. So in this case, here we have string s1, and it's the string in quotations, -934. And here we have a sort of a float number as a string, -3.452. These are in quotations. These are being stored as strings of characters by processing. If we want to actually put these into int and float variables, then we can call the int or the float functions that we've already learned about from processing. We know that these are like processing's version of casting. And here I will get the value -934, the number, and f will get the value -3.452. So this will work, but it's only because these actually make sense as numbers. If you put something else here, like coffee cup, and you try and convert coffee cup into an integer, you're not going to get anything reasonable. Okay. So the string has to only be a number, and you can't have numbers that have other stuff in it, like dollar signs or anything like that. So this will not work because we've got a comma in it. In this string, we've got 1,234, which we would think means 1,234. When we try to convert that into an int, it's actually going to print out a zero because it doesn't know how to take this number and convert it into a number. And in terms of a float, it's actually, if we try to convert that into a float, it's going to print out NaN, not a number. So these are common errors that you have to be careful about. So there's really limits to what can be converted. And you can't do things like this, where you say string S3 equals 4, the number 4 spelled out. You can't convert that to an int. If you do this and you print it out, you get 0. So it doesn't work. So this has limitations on how much you can do in terms of converting from strings into numbers. It only works if the strings really are just basic numbers. So here's a final example. If we want to get input from the user and treat it as a number, then we're going to use the JOption pane that we used before, where we got text from somebody, but we're going to actually pass what we get back from this, the string, into the int operator. And if you type in a number, this should work and give you a diameter, which can then be used to draw this on screen. So let's have a quick look at how this works. Here's this code. It's exactly what you see here. We import JOption pane, we set our size, and we ask for the diameter, and then we draw an ellipse. So if we run this, here's our input box. I will draw a circle. What diameter do you want? If I say 20, then I get this tiny little circle. Okay. If I run this again and I say 200, then I'm going to get a much bigger circle. Okay. Now, if I run this and I don't give it a number, if I give it my name, I don't get a circle. And that's because it will convert my name. It'll try and convert it into an integer. It won't be able to do it. And the integer will be 0. And so we're getting a 0 diameter circle here. All right. So hopefully that shows you the idea between converting from strings to numbers like ints and floats, and converting from numbers into strings and how you go about doing that. All right. Thanks for watching.